Hi YouTube, this is Andrew from Andrew and Melissa O, where we have a channel focused on sharing our experiences, tips and tricks on love, health and abundance. In today's video, I'd like to share with you some thoughts on a book I just finished, which you can see here, called Conscious Language, The Logos of Now, the discovery code and upgrade to our new conscious human operating system, by Robert Tennyson Stevens. I just finished this book in the first week of January this year, and a lot of different things have blown my mind because it really talks about how so much of the way, the words that we choose and the way we choose to speak reflects so many limits and so much confusion that manifests itself in everybody's lives because that's what we use. So, for example, one of the first limiting words that they talk about in the book is the word want. And the word want literally means lack. And the two other words that go with want are can't, which equals cannot, and need, which equals requiring without yet acquiring. And so these three words they suggest to remove from your vocabulary completely. Instead of want, just to give you a quick example, you could say, I choose. Right, so instead of saying, I want to go for a walk later today, a conscious way of saying that would be, I choose to go for a walk later today. Choose, by the way, is a very powerful word, according to this book. So use it in a sentence today and see how it feels to you. Okay, I just have a few notes about the book I wanted to share, and I'll just go through them. So there's different domains that they talk about of language and the different like ways in which that we limit ourselves with the way we speak. And another one is called, let's see, the domain of conditional choice. And so one of the limiting statements that really resonated with me was, I'm committed to success in order to have my dad love me. And for me, that would be more like my parents. Like, not so much right now, but definitely when I was in school, both high school and college, I, without a doubt, focused on good grades and good homework assignments and all that stuff, just because I wanted to have my mom and dad love me. That's all. I knew that they would be happier and I would feel more loved if I got better grades. So anyways, that's like a limiting statement. That's assuming that your parents do not unconditionally love you. The domain of process without outcome. A section of the book talks about the way we use language is actually confusing and does not process in your mind to have an actual outcome. So let me just share. So when you say something that ends with, oh, I'm working on it, like you say, you know, you're writing a book or you are doing some kind of a project that's, I guess, typically requires a little more than just like a, you know, a few steps. Something that you could say writing a book, right? So someone who has been wanting to write a book, even if it's a short book for their, about their life maybe, they, you know, say, they say, I'm working on that book. It's like, okay, well, here's the consequence. And working on it and working on it does not state an outcome, only the process of working on it. I am working on being forgiving does not forgive. So yeah, so just basically it confuses your mind because the statement working on it isn't specific enough and doesn't have any outcome, or because you're just being very vague. This really resonated with me because throughout my whole life, I have felt like that so many people, pretty much everyone who I've ever encountered, and I felt this myself too, that there's like this condition or like this something, some kind of a feeling that you're conditioned with from being really young, where like you're almost encouraged not to say what you really mean, and yeah, basically just like have an open heart and like be able to actually express what you really feel. And this quote by Albert Einstein really resonated with that. Few are those who see with their own eyes and feel with their own hearts. I was like, wow, that's so true. Like, how many people can actually say that they're happy? You know, people say they're living the dream or they're happy. But, you know, what does that even mean? Like, yeah. I mean, I have to say that I feel very fortunate that I'm very happy with who I am and where I'm going and the people in my life. And yeah, I feel grateful for that. But I feel like so many people who I know lie about that. That's just like the blatant truth. Because like, yeah, you could say I'm judging them. But at the same time, like, you know, you observe their habits, you observe their moods, you observe their body language, which often says a lot more than what they're saying. So anyways, this was just a quick review of this book. I've been really wanting to read it for a long time. You see, if you catch me, I said the word want. So what you say when you say a mistake, you say, clear that thought. I have really been choosing, I have chosen to read this book, and I had been desiring to, my desire was to read it for a long time, and now I have. And I imagine I will revisit this book at some point in the future. Because there's just so much in there, and you know, I'm able to apply some of it now. However, there's so much that I'm likely to forget and need to, you know, refresh my memory on all of it. If you have any comments or questions on this book or anything else about the video, please comment right below. And if you enjoyed this video, if you got something out of it, click the like and subscribe to our channel. It really helps us out. Right down below. All the best.